Hey guys, welcome back to another VOG episode. Today I'm here with Elroy1517. Today we're going to be reviewing the 2015 BullHorn BH-15, also known as the Dodge Ram 1500. Now the specific trim we're going to be looking over today is the single cab default, the default trim. It's like a 20K. It's easily affordable. And it's a pretty good performance and has a lot of history behind it. So let's just get into this, guys. So there's a lot of history behind this truck. I'm pretty sure if I remember correctly from Google, it dates back all the way to the 1940s and 50s, back when America was severely struggling in economics. So when they came out with their very first Dodge Ram, it looked like any normal truck, except it looked more of a hot rod instead of a truck. I mean, it did have like a long bed and all, but the front just looked like a hot rod. But it came a long way throughout these past like 75 years. I'm pretty sure 2020 marked the Dodge Ram's 75th anniversary from the first generation, so that's pretty cool. So I'm pretty sure this truck is mainly used for like work duties, DOT, and some police departments even have these equipped for utility vehicles. And this is just like your average truck. This is what every trucker dad wants for a starter. So anyways, what do you think of it? What do you think of the truck? It's a big truck. Well, not really. I think it's like average size and about the size of like a minivan with ridiculous sized tires and high suspension. It's bigger than me, at least. Well, it's about the size as you. I don't know what you mean. The truck bed is though. So now that we've reviewed what this truck is mainly used for, let's go over some features. So here we have the iconic Dodge Ram or Dodge grill in general. We have the bumper. We have like everything a truck needs. It's a single cab, small bed. Small truck. Well, I think with like that extra little compartment there, it would just be a minivan with ridiculous suspension, almost like a Ford Bronco. So anyways, now that that's done, let's review its performance with the startup.
I'm gonna be honest, I'm probably gonna have a stay silent like most of the things. Holy god, the baby is hyper.
So there's the startup. Let's honk. There's the honk. Well, let's rev. There we go. Now our lights just turned on automatically, and the time was set automatically since this is my VIP server. I don't know how anyone did that. So before we even continue forth, I'm gonna set the time back to 10. There we go. And now we can successfully continue this video by first off revealing the speed. All right, let me know when you're ready so I could do the three honk sequence and begin the launch.
I am ready.
All right.
I'm gonna be honest, I don't have my game audio on.
So I'm pretty sure I clocked the 0 to 60 time in around 9.5 seconds, and this is a 8-speed automatic and manual. What are you doing? But the top speed is, if I remember correctly,
131.
Thank you very much. Which is equal to 211 kilometers an hour and 231 steps per second. Now, let's check the braking.
I did a drift.
That's the best braking I've ever seen on a truck. So now that the performance reveal is done, let's go over some engine specifics. Alright, so here we are at Twist to discuss the engine specifics, the towing capacity of this truck, the durability, the weight, and the, what is going on back there?
Sorry.
It's alright, but anyways.
There's a baby running around the house.
So, anyways, this truck comes in a variety of different vehicles. Well, engines, three of them to be specific. It has a 3.0 liter V6, a 3.0 liter six cylinder, and a 5.8 liter V8 diesel, if I'm not mistaken, and which can carry between 241 to 605 horsepower, depending on which engine type you use. And there's actually an SRT version of this, which is genius of Dodge, since they're most known for their straight 8 cars. And trucks, which is this one right here. So the towing capacity is about between 2 and 3 tons. So it can lift from around 3,000 pounds to 3,000 pounds to 6,000 pounds, and it's normally a truck used for like emergency services. Well, this one specifically is used for like special services, like the Department of Transportation and police services and fire services. And this is basically just a work truck. I highly recommend for anybody with a trucker dad to get this for a starter. So like this can be their starter truck. And just everything about it fits so well, like the speed, the performance, the engine, what it's used for, how many people it can hold, and just everything about it is just so successful. And I would rate this car a solid 10 out of 10. Anyways, as I was saying, I would rate this truck a solid 10 out of 10 for just being a perfect starter for anyone with a trucker dad. And just everything about it. I don't know how many times I've said everything about it, but everything about this truck is perfect. It's a perfect starter for anybody who wants to do a farmer role play in Greenville. They could do a dot role play, they could do an emergency services role play, any kind of that such. So anyways, I would give this a solid 10. Elroy, what do you think? What would you rate this car, and tell me why?
It's like a pretty useful truck. Like, it seems pretty useful. I'd probably give it like an 8 or 7, like probably like an 8.5, probably like a 7.5 actually.
Okay.
It's outranked by the school bus because it's funny.
Yeah, you love to use Miss Frizzle's special gadgets. You love to use Miss Frizzle's secret gadget. But anyways, since our episode is officially finished, let's time lapse our drive back to spawn and end the video. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. If you like what you saw, then hit the like button and leave your thoughts about this truck in the comments below. And feel free to subscribe if you haven't already, because only 6% of you actually watch my channel. So subscribing would be a big help to my channel. And just thank you for those of you who have already. You are truly helping me proceed through this, like, you know, little career I'm having. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Let us know what suggestions we should do. And If you want to join my roleplay server, you can't be under 13. You have to be 13 or older in order to join Discord, in a matter of fact, because you have to be 13 in general to use any social media platforms by that fact. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for a brand new VOG episode.